Delaware and Miami and Philadelphia and Baltimore and all that stuff. But anyway, just a little background. My name is Dana and I'm from Delaware. I went to University of Delaware for undergrad, Hispanic World of Art and Design for graduate school. I started painting when I was 8 years old. My grandmother was a watercolor artist and she sat me down at her kitchen table, paintbrush and paper, started painting. And she set up, she always did still lifes. So she set up a vase and a rose. And I remember painting the vase and rose and it was very abstract. And the reason why it was abstract is I was trying to get the colors correct. It wasn't about what I was painting, it was about trying to produce the color of it. So that's why I decided to go to art school and paint, and I'm obviously a non-representational abstract painter. So I love painting large, as you can see. I wish I could paint larger, but my apartment in Brooklyn can't get a lot of things down the hallway, so I'm limited. So I love color fields, and you know, some of my influences are Mark Rothko, Barnett Newman, Clifford Still, all of that stuff. But so I don't really like telling people exactly what goes behind each painting, because I think that's for me. But just to give an example, there's tons of layers behind each one of these paintings. I know what you see on the surface is solid color, but the layers are charcoal, pencil, pen, tons of oil, pastel I use a lot. A lot of my older paintings in grad school were a little bit more chaotic because I showed people exactly what I was thinking. A lot of my paintings stem from dreams and anxieties and the art world and just trying to live in New York and make it as an artist. But I figured that I could calm myself down a little bit by not necessarily showing all of those layers and hiding them behind the complete color surface of what I painted. And this whole body of work is, you know, just recently living in New York, I've been there for 9 years now, and it's crowded, and there's people everywhere, and my anxieties have gotten, you know, the best of me sometimes. And so there's people all around, and so I see these as like my head paintings, kind of. So like all the big circles that I use, they're more of people's, faces, but they're all blocked out, obviously. But there's a lot behind it. This one, for example, is called Jeff Koons' Purple Berries. And Jeff Koons is an artist who lives in New York City that I don't really care for that much. And that's okay, because that's my opinion. I respect him because he's an artist. I just don't like what he does. And so, you know, some of my paintings are about dreams and, you know, the anxieties that I have to deal with. And then it's also about the anxieties of other artists who are just trying to make it, you know, and as a painter. And you know, so these are his purple berries, his blue and purple berries, which he has a show right now with me, unfortunately. I hope I'm not jumping around too much. I am a little nervous. I love thinking large, and I did this. I was fortunate enough last summer to quit my full-time job, and I was working for an artist full-time. And I quit that, and I work part-time now, but I did a series on paper because I have a really hard time painting small because I don't have the movement. I like moving around, and so I struggled with myself several times. So I started doing these paper series, and in 3 months of the summer of working part-time, I was able to produce 50 works on paper. And that's why they're titled, WOP, Work on Paper, for April 1st, 2013. So what I just titled them that day that I was able to finish. And I would finish three in about 8 hours. And I struggled with some of them are terrible. And some of them I just kept doing it because I found that the space is limited in New York City that you have to be able to be mobile. You have to move it around. I'm very happy to be able to show some of my paper pieces, which I've never shown before. With all of my large-scale paintings, which is pretty exciting for me, I think. And then I know that so this was about things that is an artist and making it there. And then the painting over here called Birthday Card, which is the green and then the yellow heads. That was a dream that I had. My father passed away 2 years ago, and I had a dream that he was like giving me this birthday card, and I didn't understand, you know, why, because it wasn't my birthday, you know. And so this was basically based on the dream that I had of his. And it basically it's like a table, a round table, with five heads that were in the dream as well, and that was all the people that were in the dream. And the big green head at the left is him, and then all of the lines are him opening the card and shutting it, opening the card and shutting it. Just to give you a little example of a painting that has more layers that you can see, rather than I didn't necessarily hide. Does anybody have any questions?
Where do you live?
I live in Williamsburg. Yeah, I've been there for 9 years.
I'm from Bay Ridge.
Oh, there you go. I work part-time in Bay Ridge. Yeah, for an artist. Yeah. But, no, I mean, Brooklyn's great, but I just wish the hallways were a little bigger. Because I really do love, I mean, when I went to grad school, I used to hang canvas just stapled to the wall. We had a big freight elevator also. So I worked in a wood shop there, so I was able to build all of my stretchers and things like that. But I would just staple canvas to like the whole entire wall in the studio and just go at it. And you know, still have all this being rolled up. And, on the floor, so So I'm constantly rotating around the paintings. If not, it's on the wall. You know, I'll paint some part, I'll flip it to one side, paint some other part, flip it to another side. And then when I go to photograph it, when I know it's finished, there's nothing else that I can do. So then I go to photograph it, and as I photograph all four sides. And then I stand there, it takes me a long time to decide, but then I stand there and I say, well, this looks best for me. And so this is how it works.
But this is how they look best to you today.
Yes.
But tomorrow you might come and switch them around?
No, it's done.
It's done?
Yeah.
Forever?
It's time on back, it's done.
Oh, I see. Yeah. Okay, so when I buy it, I have to put it up this way?
Well, I mean, as a buyer in your house, I guess you could hang it however you would like, but I would appreciate it if you wanted to buy it.
Okay, just wanted to show you. But you might come and visit.
I mean, if I came to your house to visit and see the painting, it better be on the right way.
All right. Now, that's the kind of answer I'm looking for.
Yes, yes, yes. I'll bring the wine if you buy a painting.
Okay,
yes, definitely.
Okay.
Yes.
I like your little fish. The small ones. That's why I look at it, which goes with
work. Oh, yeah, thank you. Yeah, it's so funny how much I struggle with small works. Like, even these canvases.
I love
them.
They,
like, these little tiny, it's like so. Just hard. I feel like there's something missing from it. And so I probably work harder on the little ones than I do on the bigger ones. You know, there's more layers on the bigger ones, but the smaller ones I just struggle with a lot. Maybe because I can't, you know, like I said, when I paint on the floor also, I'm moving all around them all the time. You know, the little ones, they're just so intimate. It's tough, you know?
So, thank you.
Yeah. Any other questions?